The rains, which started early September, have caused soil erosion in most parts of the region. This has left crops washed away and made some roads impassable. With the hilly nature of the region, the unpredictable weather patterns have become a threat to farmers. Farmers are worried of a possible famine outbreak in the future. They add that even the remaining crops have been destroyed. This rain has affected our gardens as farmers. It has swept away all the hills, and in future we could be struck by famine. The good farming practices that farmers used to employ back in the time have been ignored by most of them, leaving us at a greater risk. The rain has completely swept away our gardens. The trees that used to hold the running water were cut down, and that is why rain is sweeping away our gardens. We shall not survive the famine with this destruction. If these rains continue at this pace, we shall be hit by famine. Initially, we would be having trees surrounding our plantations, but they were all gone. Some environmentalists in the region attribute the growing challenge to poor agricultural practices. They also condemn poor wetland management practices in the area.
The seasons, the rainy seasons, tend to affect agriculture, you know, because of the poor agricultural practices. We've witnessed a lot of landslides in the rural communities. The roads have been blocked for those people who harvest. They don't have where to, you know, to how best to carry their produce. And definitely that is a big challenge.
The wetlands are being used. We are saying, let people not use the wetlands. But as a nation of Uganda, we are saying, let us use the wetlands sustainably. And when we talk of sustainably, we want us to use the wetlands. But even the future generation also use the wetlands. We have a number of activities that we are doing. Maybe our farmers that are in the wetlands, they can do some other projects like beekeeping. And actually, Uganda itself is giving out bees, beehives.
Milton Kwesiga, an environmentalist, has tasked the government to implement environmental conservation policies.
People are putting structures in areas which are prone to floods. People are blocking water channels. People are building on valleys. People are putting those structures, and the government is looking on. So why should we allow such people, for example, put structures in wetlands?
Chigezi sub-region, which consists of Kabale, Kanungu, Chisoro, Rukunjiri, Ruchiga and Rubanda district, has been affected by the inconsistent weather patterns. Story by Job Namanya for the news in Chigezi.